An input quality engineer has received the incoming parts together with their measurement report provided by the supplier. When he repeated the measurement in his lab, he found out that some of the parts appeared to be out of the specification. This was quite a surprise, as he not a long time before revised the supplier's quality system, and to the best of his understanding, the output inspection was satisfactory. The supplier was using a special measuring device to provide for a 100% inspection, while the customer's quality engineer was using the coordinate measuring machine. This problem is part of a broader issue known as the comparison of the measuring devices. As mentioned in the previous video, the definition of the measured quantity can seldom be detached from the measuring device. The problem is usually not the measuring technology. It is the measured part that interacts with it. We can measure several pairs of points by a dial caliper or a micrometer or a similar device. This measurement is, of course, sensitive to the mutual position of the measuring device and the measured object. The usual solution is to stabilize the tool so that the measuring faces assume a surface-to-surface contact with the measured object. However, this is not generally achievable. If we inspect the measured part more closely, we find there are no planes, nor are they parallel. The level of this problem is variable, and it claims its price in relation to the desired precision of the measurement. The more precise measurement we need, the higher is the relative influence of the little imprecisions. Besides, we also need to realize what the nature of the obtained results is. As it is one pair or a set of pairs of points, the measurement treats the larger deviations of the surface in a specific way. If the surface patterns are equidistant, the obtained measurements will often be smaller than the functional size of the part. If we repeat the measurement several times, we end up not with one result, but with several. We need to have a good definition of the measured quantity to determine which one is the right one. It can be the minimum, or maximum, or mean, or some other function of the obtained measurements. The other possibility is to station the measured block on a flat surface and to measure the height with a ball-shaped probe. This form of measurement cannot be said to be better or worse. It has its own pros and cons. On the bottom, there is a surface-to-surface contact, which emphasizes the extremes and which is quite sensitive to the flatness of the measuring surface. Though it is possible to make the surface reasonably flat, it is never perfect, and it cannot be expected to stay that way if it is used frequently. On the top, the ball tip ensures a point contact, or a very small area, depending on the tip radius, which is much more stable. This setup has an infinite number of possible modifications. We may, for example, add one more probe to the bottom. Now the measured value is less sensitive to the flatness of the measured surface, the contact points are consistent on the top and on the bottom, and they preserve a point contact, being less sensitive to the small-scale surface irregularities compared to the flat contact of the micrometer. Now we are only one step away from the special measuring devices, and here you can let your fantasy run wild. The part can be rotated under the probes, obtaining a set of measurements on a circular path. It can be adapted to semi-automated version, mitigating the influence of the operator. With a slight adaptation of the tips, the measurement can be used in a fully automated measuring line for a 100% check. If other properties of the surface are of interest, more probes can be added, and their mutual positions can be analyzed.
The special measurement devices offer adaptations to all possible specifications of the measurement process. Their limitation, on the other hand, is the uniqueness of the application. They are not very universal, and they require specialized competency, both in the design and maintenance process.
And let us present one more. The universal coordinate measuring machine uses a spherical stylus or an optical scanning device to acquire a number of points on the measured surface, and then it processes these points by approximating them with the measured feature. Especially with scanning, the acquired points are quite comprehensive description of the measured part, and the dominant portion of the measurement is the subsequent data treatment in the measuring device's software. Here we need to employ the knowledge of the measured quantity definition. We need to decide what shall be the base of the measurement, which features will define the coordinate system, if the surfaces should be approximated by planes, or if we care about some specific function of the acquired data.
The price for the universality of these machines is a lower precision of measurement, vulnerability to harsh environment, and longer measurement times.
Besides the process consideration, like the universality, cycle time, and robustness, the different measurement devices will always produce slightly different description of the measured feature. On one hand, there is a natural requirement to have comparable results from the different measurement devices. On the other, the specific interaction between the measuring devices and the measured object will always influence the result. In the real-life circumstances, we often see a clear need to bring these seemingly incompatible sides together.
For instance, we need to link the shop floor measurement that is used to control the production machines to the end-of-line measurement or to the quality inspection laboratory measurements. This problem is especially important when it comes to the comparisons between the output inspection on the supplier's side to the input inspection on the customer's side. None of these are precise. The individual numbers can never be the same, and it only makes sense to ask how different they can be.
Let me present two different approaches.
First, if one of the devices is primarily used to decide on the part's quality and maybe to control the production, then the measuring device shall be checked for a significant difference from the previously measured value. The significance of the difference is dependent on the measurement uncertainty of the individual devices. If the measured value is, let's say, 10.235 plus or minus 0.025 millimeters on one device, and 10.28 plus or minus 0.03 millimeters on the other, the measured values are not different, or more precisely, the measurement did not prove them to be different. Of course, to make such statement, we need to know the measurement uncertainty, which has to account also for the specific difference in the measured quantity definition. With the same measurement technologies, we can expect a closer match in the more precise parts. Please note that this comparison is not linked to the tolerances of the measured feature. One device may find the part within the tolerances and the other not. Yet, they can still be proclaimed the same.
Second, if the compared measuring devices are used interchangeably, or if none of them can be seen as the primary one, we must consider them to be part of one measurement process and the difference between them to be a component of measurement process uncertainty. Please remember that measurement is never precise. No matter how hard we try, we can never know the exact size. The trouble with comparing the different measuring devices is only a consequence of this fact.